We got a problem?
Hey, I don't think I know you.
I'm Claire. You might not remember me. Bartender at the Afterlife?
Uh-oh. Forgot to close my tab?
Bar has a buzz about you lately. As the merc who's reliable, gets things done. And since I need help...
Okay.
Need a driver for street races. Drop by my auto shop. I'll tell you more.
Your garage, where is it?
In Arroyo, on Valley. Lovely spot. Can't miss it.
All right. I'll try not to.
If I'm not there when you arrive, just hang. I'll show up after my shift at the after.
Okay. See you, Claire.
Got a call about a cyber psycho and actually sent a patrol this time, but it's been a few hours with no report back. Either those cops got scared and bounced, or anyway, could you check it out for me? Be much appreciated.
Finally scrounged up enough eddies to pay you back in full.
Hold on to them, just in case. You need them more than me.
I'm not taking them all the way to my grave, Vic. Here. And thanks again for doing so much work on me without ever seeing an any.
That's what friends are for.
Listen. Don't laugh, but... been seeing some weird shit around town. Like, murals or something. But I know they're not real.
Just a Kiroshi blip. Could take a look.
No, no. The images are too complex for a blip. It's like they're symbols.
That case is the biochip. Brain can't handle the data overload. Either that, or it's reached the cortex.
Can you do anything?
Nope. Better find a way to get rid of that chip.
Got a few questions about Silverhand and this chip.
I'm no expert, but fire away. See what I can do.
How's it even possible, seeing him?
Well, that biochip is designed for users to communicate with constructs. It's just doing its job.
So I got Arasaka to thank.
You know, I wager you have the lowest net worth of any relic owner out there.
Tried to flatline me. Johnny did.
What?
What can I do to suppress him? You know, avoid my murder.
Well, long as you don't give him control, can't do too much harm. Of course, that won't necessarily be possible after some time.
And what then?
What do you say we don't let things get that far? Find a way to get rid of Silverhand, and fast.
Why am I reliving Johnny's memories?
You two share a brain now. He has access to your senses, perceptions, even some memories. Likewise, you've got a glimpse into his. After a while, won't even know whose is whose.
Was thinking about swapping some chrome. You got any new toys?
Have a look.
Saw a weird image out on the street. Seems like your line of work.
What'd it look like?
I grabbed a scan. Take a look.
Tarot. Major Arcanum. What you saw was a sign from a higher power.
The what now? Major Arcanum?
Tarot card, archetype, knowledge held in symbolic form, a stage in your journey through life. Take your pick.
Either way, you're saying some higher power's talking to me through tarot cards.
Or to Silverhand. Or both of you, seeing as you form a harmonious whole at the moment.
You know, it'd be a little easier if this higher power learned to be direct.
Well, the world is a maze of illusions. It's not easy for the light to shine into the prison of our earthly existence.
Right. Great. So, what do I do with a sign I can't understand from a power I know nothing about?
I'd start by looking for more of them. The tarot describes a road, so go down it.
Still don't know what I'm supposed to do with what I find.
Look for more images. They must have some connection to the place where you find them. Think about what you see. You ask me? They've been sent to help you find the truth.
Finding the truth is pretty far down on my list at the moment.
A difficult time is coming when you'll have to choose which road to take. Then, you'll understand.
I don't know.
Come on back when you've found more. I'll help you decipher what you've seen.
And I tell you, no! We aren't nothing ordinary. And I tell you, no! The Arathakas are no ordinary clan. They're not even human! Vampire, Vamont! Remain undead. I tell you now, Saburo is not gone from our world. He rests undisturbed in the family crypt. He feasts on the blood of his servants, awaiting his body's rejuvenation to return.
Wouldn't be a total shocker. Said on TV, Arasaka's working on immortality tech.
A hollow lie to conceal their inhuman nature. Its source flows not through technology, but through their undead blood. But how could mere mortals become these death-defying abominations, you ask? With the help of techno-necromancers from Alpha Centauri. It was their tainted blood Saburo Arasaka drank to transform himself into this devil spawn.
Gary, you can't spill Arasaka's secrets. They gon' find you.
Let them! The seed has been sown. The truth shall sprout roots and lift us from the invaders' clutches!
I recognize you. You come here often. Your eyes tell me that your mind has opened to the truth. Will you provide a humble donation so that I may continue my mission?
You do good work. Use this to wake Night City up.
Thank you for your devotion. I saw a disciple of truth in you from the very beginning.
Radio waves bear the truth. Let those with ears listen and those with eyes behold. is life without its body? What are the beings of the net if not souls from beyond our plane of existence? I have heard their voices. Let they who yet live never cross that threshold, for their souls will join those ghostly ranks.
You heard their voices? What did they say?
They spoke not in the language of mortals, no. They howled, screaming in agony, forever removed from their earthly form. Among them was a woman, her voice of ice, Queen Lilith. She was calm, but at the cost of her humanity. You ask, who opened these unholy gates of the abyss?
No one's asking.
And I answer you, the Techno-Necromancers of Alpha Centauri!
I recognize you. You come here often. Your eyes tell me that your mind has opened to the truth. Will you provide a humble donation so that I may continue my mission?
Do good work. Use this to wake Night City up.
Thank you for your devotion. I saw a disciple of truth in you from the very beginning.
Since we're gonna work together, only right to say hello. They call me El Capitan, and they call you Lee.
See, no introduction's necessary. I already took care of that.
Someone comes to me with biz, I take care of it. I eat, sleep, and breathe biz. Remember that.
Aye, aye, Captain.
While we're at it, you need fresh wheels, bikes? I got it all. Real good prices. So hit me up anytime, you hear?
Say Aetherus is an AI. Explains why he finishes top at every tournament.
Table, we got to get rid of it.
Really? It's pretty massive.
V, nice to see you. Oye, sit. Sit. You want a beer?
Wouldn't mind one.
Salud. A lot of time has passed. How you been?
Been better, to tell you the truth.
What is happening?
That night, when Jackie fell. Let's just say things haven't exactly been easy since.
Yo sé cómo te sientes. Todos lo sabemos. I am in the middle of preparing an ofrenda. There is still so much to take care of.
An ofrenda? What's that exactly?
Friends and family. We gather to celebrate the departed. Our memories of them. And we bring things they loved in life and might need in the after.
Sure some beer'd be at the top of Jackie's list.
And there will be beer.
Could help you with that.
Gracias, mi cielo. But I will manage. It's enough you come to say goodbye.
Want to take part in the ceremony, but want to do it the right way, in line with tradition.
Mm-hmm.
But something I'd lay by his casket, that'd do justice to his memory. I don't got anything.
Mm. But your heart is in the right place, mi niño. Don't worry. He's symbolic. Look for something in his garage. His past is all there.
Jackie had a garage?
He used it for his motorcycle, mostly. But not so long ago he moved in. You'll find something there, I'm sure.
You won't mind me digging through his stuff?
No, mijo. He's gone, and funerals are for the living, not the dead. Toma, take the key.
Thanks, Mama Wells.
Don't mention it, V. You have respect. I admire that. The garage is on Republic. Ahí te veo. A dozen cases, too. Take lemons and limes to match. You can't.
Ivy.
You here alone? This is not exactly the safest neighborhood in town, Misty.
I used to sit on the stairs when I was 10. 26 now. If anything was gonna happen, it wouldn't have taken this long.
What are you doing here?
Sitting and waiting. And yeah, waiting for him. Though I know he's never coming back. Lately, I've just been coming here to sit. An hour. Sometimes, too. I know it's gonk, it's just... I miss him. A lot. Wanna sit? Catch up?
Hardly gonk at all. Just, well... human.
I guess.
You know each other long?
Half our lives. Grew up in the same streets. Saw each other a lot, but... just never got together.
Till a year back.
Yeah. Best darn year of my life.
Jack talked about you a lot. Always saying how much you meant to him.
Did he really say that? I bet he used different words.
Maybe. But that's what he meant. I really believe that.
You actually got to know him. The real Jackie. Everybody else thought he was a goofball with a rough-hewn face and an edge. But they're wrong.
What did you see in him?
Let me tell you what he told me once. Told me he'd take a bullet for me. In an instant. Even if it'd kill him.
Spoken like a true Haywood boy.
A man. With dreams, ambitions. Only thing they cost him was his life. There's a huge chunk of his past in there.
How come you're outside?
I don't have the key.
Jackie never gave you a set. You two didn't get that far?
He offered, but I wanted him to have his own space. Just his own.
Mama Wells is having a send-off for Jackie. I need to find something he really cared about. Mind giving me a hand?
I'm not sure I should go in there, V.
Still too soon?
No, it's not that. Mama Wells and I aren't exactly on the best terms. She wouldn't want me touching any of his things, disturbing the memory. That I know.
Jackie would want you here. That's more important. Come on. Gotta be hanging here since 2020. Jackie loved to pump iron, didn't he?
He called it his form of meditation. He used to say barbells are the best listeners. They understand all your problems and never give you gonk advice.
Guess no man cave's complete without some of those, huh?
He said they're collectibles. They don't print them anymore.
That's definitely why they're up there. Yeah. Still full.
His favorite. Strategic reserve. No touching.
How come?
¿Por qué no puedes tocar una reserva estratégica, va?
Well, looks like he swapped out the exhaust pipe.
What?
I advised him to do it. Right before the job. Love to poke around engines.
He was 15 when he first got on a bike.
Knowing him, it's a miracle he never wiped out. For Whom the Bell Tolls, Ernest Hemingway.
Jack read it a dozen times, always right before a big job. He said the guy who wrote it was tougher than Morgan Blackhand.
Have you read it? Is it any good?
I never got the chance.
It'd be a good tribute for the ofrenda, though.
Oh, Jackie.
That a mandala?
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's a long story.
Hey, you all right?
I'm so much better than all right. I once told Jackie he should sweep all the dark energy out of this place. A sand mandala would do the trick, for example. He told me that out of sand, he'd build a castle, a home, the Wells family hideout, stronghold, something.
I guess you made a bigger impression than you thought.
I guess I did.
It's beautiful.
It's hideous. But it's also the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
An aquarium.
It used to be tacos.
And Taco was...
his fish. A dwarf shark. Like, mini.
Sounds like a mighty expensive fish.
Oh, I don't think he bought it.
Nice still. Leather belt.
Sort of a memento. His dad's. He used to beat both Jackie and his mom with it. Until one day, Jackie fought back. Kicked his butt. Told him he'd kill him next time. Old man was hospitalized, and then he left.
Why'd he hold on to it?
In case his dad ever comes back. Jackie's favorite tequila. Oh, still sealed. It's his lucky charm. One of the first bottles ever made by Jesus de Abajo.
The founder of Sansón Tequila.
Only 100 of them left in the world. All owned by the 1%.
Well, how'd Jackie get this one?
Some shriveled abuela in Mexico sold it to him. Told him de Abajo had stolen her recipe.
Taking this, yeah. Perfect for Jackie.
Well, you got something for your ofrenda. But we could look around a little more.
True memento, this. Jack, pure and simple. Better get going.
Actually, I think I'll stay a while. Say bye to him here. Mama Wells wouldn't want me there anyway.
What happened between you two? What's the beef?
Let's just say she didn't see me as daughter-in-law material.
What'd she have against you?
That my name wasn't Camila and I wasn't Jackie's ex-output. Camila was Mama Well's favorite.
Right. You gotta come, Misty. You got a right to be there.
I'd rather not get in Mama Well's way. It's for family.
You were family to him.
I guess you're right. Thanks, V. So, shall we go?
You ever thought you might leave Night City?
Sure. Once upon a time, I even tried.
Seriously? Meaning?
Packed my bags and hopped on a plane to Nepal. Thought I'd stay there. After a week, I realized I couldn't live without the traffic outside my window and my neighbors hollering.
Good you're here. We're about to start. Sit down, please.
Hey, V.
I thank you all for coming today. I'm not going to tell you what kind of man my son was, or lament about how much I miss him. Instead, tell you a story. When he was about 19 years old, Jackie was in the Valentinos. They were at war with Maelstrom back then. I get a call from the hospital. They tell me he got shot 3 times, just by the heart. He was conscious when I get there. So many tubes coming out of him. He looked like a pulpo, like an octopus or something. He tell me, he said, "No te preocupes, mama. Look, I'm bulletproof. Nothing bad will ever happen to me." And when I go, he take off his Valentino's ring. He swear he won't need it anymore. But he was not scared. He just didn't want me to worry. Descansa en paz, mi hijo.
Among the membership of the Night City Devils Boxing Club, we had this saying: make your best friends among the fighters who knock you out cold. And it's true. Jackie's arm was a cannon. No one's ever hit me as hard. I can still almost feel it. Twelve rounds, buddy.
Mandó Camporta. Lamenta no estar aquí. Todavía le quedan 4 años que cumplir. Me pidió que leyera esto. Recuerdo cuando Jackie se nos unió. Era un niño fuerte. Cuando decía que iba a hacer algo, cumplía. Tenía honor. Podría haber llegado lejos. Mis condolencias a la familia. Que descanse en paz.
Anyone else?
I often think back to the first time me and Jack met. I'd been hired to drive him and some contraband across the border. He bought some goods clept from Arasaka. Top secret. Priceless. A lizard. And, I remember what he said then. That I came from a place where everyone's family. So he must be too. Jackie Wells. Best friend you could ask for. Loyal to a fault. Once he set his mind to something, he was ready to die to achieve it. He once told me, Broder, the one thing we can't do is be afraid of others. He always knew what he wanted, and he took it without asking. Most importantly, Jackie loved life and had no fear. Heart on his sleeve, he didn't overthink things. He just went for it. Thought he was bulletproof. And that he'd become legend at the afterlife. And ultimately, he did what he set out to do. Shit in the shoes of some powerful people. And if he's watching, I bet just about now, he's flipping them all the bird. He always wanted more than he got out of life. Rest easy, Chu.
I would like to say a toast. Por mi hijo. Thank you for your kind words, Lee. I'm glad you're here. It was a beautiful ofrenda we gave him. A lot of people come today. Even that putica Jackie was messing around with.
Her name is Misty.
What?
Misty. And she was very important to him. Do you understand? Go. Invite her along for dinner. It's the least she deserves.
You know what? You're a good man. Jackie would want you to have these.
You sure? Jackie would kill me if I got so much as a scratch on it.
So don't get any scratches on it.
Thank you. I'll take such good care of it.
Cuídate, B. Jackie chose his friends well.
Campos all torn up.
I'm gonna miss him.
As he feels like he lost one of his own.
I already do.
I wonder if he'll be as torn up after you die.
Me too, cabrón.
Don't go starting something.
Me too. Hey,
not today.
Here's to Jackie. Got off to greener pastures.
Jackie Wells.
A proud son of Haywood.
Well, I should mingle, Vic.
Sure. See you later, V.
Pour you another? For Jaquito?
Weird being here without Jackie.
Can't shake the feeling I'm gonna turn around and see him sitting at the bar. In his favorite spot, where he always used to sit.
Pour. For Jackie.
Amen, brother.
I'll have another.
Have as many as you want.
Hey, you! Have a drink with us, To Wells?
How'd you meet Jackie?
We started out together.
In the Valentinos?
No, in the fucking Bible Book Club.
Yeah.
I got only good memories of him. Rest easy up there, brother.
Think we might know each other.
Gustavo Horta.
V.
Yeah, I've heard about you. Well, heartfelt condolences, friend. From me, Campo, and all the Valentinos.
Thank you. All right, why not?
To Wells. May he rest in peace.
Good for now, thanks.
See? You gotta know when to stop.
Alright, give me a break. Alright, let's go.
¿Qué dijiste de mi jefecita? ¿Ya te cargó la chingada?
Lupe's been handling the loss pretty good.
She's a strong woman.
Here to say goodbye to one of your own? Padre?
I'm here to say goodbye to a good man.
How are things in the streets?
This is not the place to conduct business. Have some respect.
Jackie, do you know him well?
I remember the day his mother brought him into this world. The day his father left. The day he took you into his home. Yes, V. I knew him quite well.
So, Padre, you think Jackie's looking down upon us? From up there?
I believe he has met God, stood before him.
That's it.
I don't know if God left the meeting happy, but I'm pretty certain Jackie did.
I'm gonna move on.
Go with God.
Hey, are you all right?
Yeah, I think I'm just still in that garage, mentally. I just need a sec.
Thank you.
te metiste en un pinche pedote, ¿eh?
A ver si ya dejas de andar con tus mamadas.
Shaking.
Need to make contact with the Voodoo Boy's chief if he can swing it.
All right. Straight to heavy business. Now, that'd be Maman Brigitte. Be tough getting a word into her.
Maman Brigitte. And that sounds like a spooky cult alias.
Have not had the pleasure of asking her personally. But it is what everybody calls her. Doubt the title has any real religious weight, though. Voodoo boys play pretty fast and loose with their Haitian heritage.
Huh. I was led to believe you could arrange anything.
Ah! Now that sounded like my third wife every time she wanted a new purse.
You really don't do any biz with them?
Not with the chefs, chefins, priests, and whatnot. All got dirigible-sized egos, won't talk to lowly me. But if you insist, I can ask around, try to set something up. I'll just need some details first.
Got something they want.
Truly? Want to sell something to the VDBs? Trust me, they don't want it, they don't need it. They're isolated, insulated, they got their own contracts, tech, networks. But, have it your way. Okay, I'll see what I can do and get back to you.
Bye.
Consider this your lucky day. You hear Pacifica calling, you make sweet love to it, that is.
You got something for me?
Well, it's like I said. Whatever you're peddling, the VDBS are just not in the market. But they have another task that needs doing. So I volunteered you. Do it well, and you'll get your audience with Brigitte.
What's this task needs doing?
What? You're gonna go picky on me? The contact will fill you in on the deets. I got zero from him. Actually, got the impression I'd have to pay for every word out of his mouth.
Okay, so who do I talk to and how?
Hit the chapel on Sloane. Look for the altar inside. Someone will touch you, nod to you. Something spooky.
Got it. Thanks.
Thank you. City, welcome back. My guest tonight is Lieutenant Sarah Kokoski, spokeswoman for the NCPD. Hi there, welcome to the show.
Hello, Ziggy. Thanks for having me.
I hope you made it to the studio without any issues. No carjackings or drive-bys along the way?
No. Fortunately, the streets of Night City are getting safer every day. We've seen recorded homicides drop from 7,103 a year ago to just...
Hold on. The streets are safe, you say, but what about the highways?
I'm sorry.
You heard about the shooting off the Route 1 exit.
To see you, V.
Seems pretty, secluded here.
It is appropriate for such a secret meeting.
What the hell happened? You look close to awful.
You see a man robbed of his implants, money, and dignity. Look well. It is not all bad. I am mostly unnoticed in the streets.
Friend you mentioned here?
Oda? He should be here any moment now.
Willing finally to give me the spec on him?
He's Hanako-sama's bodyguard.
Hanako Arasaka's? From the carrier at anchor in the bay. Saburo's daughter.
Yes, and if he believes you, we'll next meet with her.
Pedro.
Sure you can trust him?
Yes.
Convincing, very.
I have nothing to lose. Is that better?
Worse, because I got plenty to lose.
By God, huh? A good sign. He is usually camouflaged. My witness, V.
Can't speak for myself, you know.
So speak. I have been told you know things.
Not gonna like what I'm about to say. I need a guarantee I'm safe here.
You are. You have it. V, you can trust Oda.
All right, then. Compeki Plaza. I was there the night it happened. Looked like your typical family quarrel until Yorinobu lunged at Saburo and started choking.
Silence! Not one word more. You will bring death to your door.
But it is the truth. Hanako-sama must hear it.
My one concern is to keep her safe in this city forgotten by the gods.
Is she in danger?
Now? No. Yet during the parade to honor Arasaka-sama, most certainly.
I bring you this witness to his murder. And you dare to worry about a silly parade? Fool!
Correct.
Unright, but you can't ignore the truth.
Correct. Unlike you, I have not yet failed to keep my oath to do my duty.
You will regret those words.
The only thing I regret is that I came here to meet you.
There is a price on your head. I do you a...
Sorry, but it's gonna take much longer.
I do you a favor now by not cutting it off and taking it straight to Yorinobu-sama. What would you do now, were you in my place?
I do no favors. I would deliver your head to Yorinobu-sama.
Consider yourself lucky.
Oda. Not like we're asking for a whole lot here. Just one brief meeting. Hanako should decide if what we say is true. You can't decide for her. Will you help?
I will not. But I will let you leave this place, this city, unharmed. If I see either of you again, I will not be so lenient.
Be very careful, my friend. We are all so far from home.
Good fucking riddance. 1 hour Sokka whack job is already plenty.
Fine friend there. Got any more?
Alas, only him.
No way this is gonna work.
Yet. We walk away with a small measure of success.
How do you figure that?
What Oda said. They return to Tokyo after the parade. Do you not see the parade? It is our chance, perhaps. If somehow we can get to Hanako-sama, we must do a proper reconnaissance first. We'll need a precise map of Japantown.
Hold on.
It is your turn to call on friends. Do you know a fixer who could help?
Hang on. Not so fast. Make it sound as easy as hacking a schism. You said yourself, Hanako's got the tightest security in all Night City.
Correct. That is why I wish for you to contact us with a local fixer.
No just to fix her dame. Kaku Okada runs a pachinko parlor on Jig-Jig Street.
We must pay this woman a visit. Will you join me?
Sure, why not?
Ah, shit! G.G. Street. What is this name?
Just a Night City name.
Beware, you mock me too often.
Any idea what's going on at Arasaka?
Only what I can surmise from what I see on TV. Yorinobu and his puppets grin at the cameras and insist that everything is under control. But the wider the smile, the bigger the lies.
You all right, Goro?
Yes. Why the sudden concern?
Have shared interests, you and I. Or have you forgotten?
Certainly not.
Good. Because catching lead in Night City is easier than catching a cold. And I need you alive.
I am alive and well, as you can see. You shouldn't worry about yourself.
No good bastard, son of a bitch! Stop right there!
What? Huh? Oh! Hey! Honey!
Hey, honey? What the fuck? What are you doing here?
Sunshine! Shh! Shh! Don't want any drama now, do we?
I do it. Yeah. Yes, tomorrow. No time yet.
Now, I may not be good with names, but I do have quite a talent for faces. Where have I seen yours before? On the TV?
Very unlikely.
But of course! Hideshi Hino! The man, the legend! In the flesh! Oh, you are just in time. Do you know who this is? Hideshi Hino, the late night comedy host! He was brilliant before he fell off the wagon. Can you still do your famous, better bugger up?
No,
Come on, you don't forget a thing like that. Just once, please. V, we should go in now.
Hideshi, don't leave this poor guy hanging.
This is not the best time, truly.
Oh, come on! I haven't heard it in years.
Beta, buckle up!
Wow.
Ino-san, what happened to you?
I do not know. I do not recognize myself. Are you happy? May we go?
Fine, let's go.
Hideshi Hino, to have fallen so far. Such a shame.
Rogue, my sweet. This has got to be a misunderstanding. I've no idea who jumped your team, but the claws? No, never. My boys know their place. I'm sorry, got to go. I have guests. V, so nice to see you. And your charming friend is?
Hideshi Hino, the comedian.
Yamero って言ってんだ。竹村五郎です。岡田さん。お会いできて光栄です。
はあ、a true gentleman. Ah, shame only that he's being hunted by all Arasaka's tin soldiers. And you, V, bring him to my door. Give me one reason why I shouldn't notify the proper authorities right away.
Eddie's is why. Always about Eddie's, Wakako. You want to make them? We got biz. Doesn't get any simpler.
So tell me, and mark well, I still have my phone at hand.
Need intel on the parade that's scheduled to come through Japantown.
So it's Arasaka again. What I fail to understand is, why come to me? Did Mr. Deshawn not come to the phone?
Goro, remind me why Dex's fat, backstabbing ass is currently indisposed.
He is deceased.
Butchered and dumped at a landfill by some Arasaka goon. Real shame that.
That a threat I detect?
No threat, no. Asked why I couldn't reach Dex. I answered. Just facts, nothing more.
Good, because you would then have to join him.
Okada-san, our intentions are honorable. We need just information. It is a matter of life and death.
Everything's on the shards.
How much does this cost? My pockets are empty.
Clearly. My gift to you, it's free.
Okada-san, what is free often proves most costly.
Gonna take them or not?
For free? You sure?
Got my reasons, but patience, I got none. Japantown. Whole district is to be sealed off for the parade. Dashi platforms, the main attraction, they'll fly this way, high above street level. Along the parade route, balconies, footbridges, and vantage points affording good views. Hanako Arasaka, a guest of honor, will deliver her speech from the largest float. She'll do this exactly here. Got no idea about security, but given recent events, expect it to be tight. Our last parade? Arasaka undercovers infiltrated the crowd. Not to mention a smattering of sharpshooters, drones. And if that's not enough fun for one day, a net runner, one at least. They use the city CCTV to observe everything. Main access point, here, It's an old automated control center. If you ask me, most useful by far. At the end, the floats afloat out of Japantown, and we'll be left with trash up to our elbows that no one will collect. That's it. It's all I have.
It must be enough.
Then go. Be on your way.
Not at all curious what we're going to all this trouble for.
Blissful ignorance has served me well. In any case, I'll find out soon, won't I?
Thanks, Wakako.
We appreciate this, Okada-san. A delightful, mature woman. This information, it could be just what we need. But I will try to investigate further. I will stay here some time and call some associates. The moment I learn something new, I will let you know.
Just low profile, okay? Don't start handing out autographs.
In fame, I could not overtake you if I tried. Be safe.
How you look is all that matters. With Angelique Cosmetics, you can be anyone and have anyone.
I'm not afraid of anyone, you know?
Got a lot of iron here.
I have a bad experience some years ago. I want insurance.
Now I'm curious.
One of my clients, he loses his mind right here in this chair. He howl like an animal, expose his blades. He charged me. Then I have no gun, only a scalpel. I try to defend myself, but I lose one eye, four fingers, and a kidney. Still, I survive it, as you see. I promise to myself every day I will not be unprepared again.
This patient of yours, cyberpsycho, you think?
I do not know. For me, cyberpsychosis is an empty word. A label we give to people who are bad, evil, from cyberware or not.
Thank you. Lust, Mayhem, Revenge, Bushido X, Fate to Black.
聞いてるか？
てこいよ。なーに。
B, I need you to acquire something. Only me, no client. So I expect quick and clean results. You will be entering Tiger Claw territory. Very high risk. More information attached.
Pray with us to the common of Chrome Scripture. You are
you
For the love of... couldn't I have been stuck in some model's skull? Or, I don't know, a fucking landscape architect?
What is it now, Johnny?
Being dragged through roach-infested flophouses again. That's what.
Job's a job. And what was that code?
What a fucking shit sty.
Wasn't slumming it in squats like your whole thing?
Sure, when I was skezzed out beyond all recognition. Just don't know why I should care.
Looks like Leia went to the Tiger Claws. Behind Wako's back.
Tisk, tisk, tisk. Claws aren't the deal on her in type.
Let's see if she got lucky.
Thank you. Desires are beyond reach. Think again. Loud. We make it happen.
Gakime! I think so many people died for this tiny little shit speck.
It's not the size that counts.
Both you and I know no one actually believes that.
Sounds spooky, but something must still be in there, right?
The Night City Office of Cybernetic Technology has been formally dissolved as a...
同僚を招くのが恥ずかしい。それなら本物のウッドフロアのマンションを借りて裕福な暮らしを見せつけてやりましょう。
You were able to find the lockbreaker. Splendid work. Keep it up. Closing the contract.
Show some respect.